Good morning, dear children. In the last class, we have seen explanation of lesson 11. In that lesson, we have seen about elephant. Elephant, we know that it is a wild animal, but in our lessons, it become a domestic animals. He enjoy with Kohinoor estate. He play with small children. Okay, he happy with living with them. So now we are going to learn exercise of lesson 11, Shanko at Kohinoor estate. In this lesson, we are going to learn singular and plural noun. We know that noun means the name of the person, place, things, idea. But what is singular and plural? Singular means only one. It could be either person, place, things, idea. Okay? Plural means more than one. More than one persons, more than one place, things, ideas. So only one means a boy, a cat, a house. Okay? These are the only one cat, only one boy, only one house. It is a singular noun. Plural noun means, okay, two cats. There are two cats. There are three boys. There are four houses. So, it is more than one place, persons, things, and ideas. Okay, this is the singular and plural. So, you keep it in your mind, my dear children. Singular means only one. Okay, it should be only one. And plural nouns means more than one. Two or three, four, five, six, seven. Okay, that is plural, more than one. Singular means only one. Now let's go for the exercise. In first exercise, they are giving one rules. We have read the word leaves. So, leaves, it is a plural noun. Leaves, it is a plural noun. What is the singular noun of leaves? It should be leaf. Okay? In singular noun of leaves, it is leaf. So, now we are going to learn how we can change the singular noun into the plural noun. What is the rules in English grammar? So, when F, okay, when singular nouns are ending with F, okay, ending with F, that is singular noun. So, how do we change as a singular noun into the plural noun? It is very simple. We should remove F, okay, end of the word, we should remove F. Instead of F, we had okay, instead of F, we have to add V-E-S. Okay, for example, here, leaf, it is a singular noun. This word is ending with A-F. So, now, we should remove F and instead of F, we have to add V-E-S. So, leaf is a singular noun, leaves is a plural noun. Here, there are six singular nouns are there. Now, we are going to change singular noun into the plural noun. So, I told you. So, how to change as a singular noun into the plural noun means we should remove F and we have to add V-E-S instead of F. Then, it convert as a plural noun. So, now make up plurals of the following words. So, calf, C-A-L-F, calf. So, now we have to change calf into a plural noun. It is calves. So, we have to remove F. Instead of F, we have to add V-E-S, end of the word. See, calves. So, calf is a singular noun. Calf is a plural noun. So, like this, we have to change the remaining five words. So, next word is thief. THIEF. So this is also singular noun. This is ending with F. So now what we have to do? We should remove F, and instead of F we have to add VES into the plural noun. See? So half. H-A-L-F, half. So half is a half word is ending with F. So we have to remove F and we have to add VES. So now house. So half is a singular noun, house is a plural noun. So now thief. I told you already, thief is a singular noun. So thief is a singular noun. This noun ending with F. So if we want to change singular noun into the plural noun, means what we have to do? Yes, my dear children, we have to remove F. Instead of F, we have to add VES into the noun. So now thief is a singular noun, thieves is a plural noun. So the fourth one, wolf. Fourth one is wolf. Wolf is a singular noun. This singular noun is ending with F. So now we have to change wolf into the plural noun. So instead of F, we have to add VES. So that means we have to remove F and we have to add VES. So wolves. So now shelf. So shelf is a singular noun. So now what we have to do to change the plural noun? We have to remove F, and instead of F we have to add VES for the plural nouns. So at last word is loaf. L-O-A-F, loaf. So this is the singular noun. Now we have to change the singular noun into the plural noun. So we have to remove F and we have to add VES. So loaves is a plural form. Yes, my dear children, exercise 4 we did now. So what we have to do? Singular nouns, and we have to change as a plural noun. From the singular noun we have to change as a plural noun. So for that, what we have to do? In your singular noun, the word is ending with F. If you want to change that singular noun into the plural noun, just we have to remove the F, and we have to, instead of F, we have to add VES to the noun, then it become a plural noun. Okay, so next exercise. When a noun ends in a consonant. Consonant we know, na? So Y. If the noun ending with the consonant Y, the Y. Okay? And add IES to make it plural. So in the last lessons we have seen, if the word is ending with F in singular noun, we have to change, we have to remove F and we have to add VES for the plural form. But in this lesson, if your singular noun ending with Y, we have to remove Y and we have to add IES for the plural noun. So now, okay, so country, the word, the singular noun is ending with a Y. So instead of Y, so country is the singular noun. So in this singular noun, if we want to change into the plural noun, what we have to do? We should remove Y, and instead of Y, we have to add IES to the noun. Then it become a plural form of noun. So now make plurals of the following words. So last exercise, we have to remove F and we have to add singular noun VES. Then it become a plural noun. So in this lesson, in this exercise, we have to remove Y from the singular noun and we have to add IES for the plural noun. Now we are going to do the exercise. So this word this noun, this singular noun is ending with y. So this is the singular noun. So now we are going to change as a plural noun. So what we have to do? Simple, we should remove y. Instead of y, we have to add ies for the plural noun. So I removed y from the singular noun and I add ies for the plural form. So now story is a singular noun and stories is a plural noun. So likewise here lady. Lady means only one. Only one lady. That is the singular noun. If it is more than one, there are group of ladies are there. Okay? Then what we have to do? That is the plural noun. So for that, how we are going to change is a singular noun into the plural noun means it is a simple. We should remove y and we have to add ies into the singular noun. See, I removed y and I had ies into the singular noun. So now ladies, it is the plural form. Lady is a singular noun. So now baby. Baby means either girl baby or boy baby. Only one baby. It is the singular noun. So now baby, we have to change into the plural form means we have to remove y and we have to add ies. So now baby become a babies. Baby is a singular noun. Babies is a plural noun. Now copy. Okay, copy is a singular noun. Either one notebook, either English notebook or science notebook or okay, but more than all the subjects notebook means that is plural noun. No, so this is copy is a singular noun. So for the plural noun we have to remove y and we have to add ies into the noun. So copies, now it become a plural, copies. So city, city means only one city. Okay, that is the referred as a place. So if it is city means only one place. So more than one place, that is the plural form. One place, it is a singular noun. So now cities, we have to city, we have to change into the plural form. For that we have to remove y and we have to add ies into the singular noun. So now cities, it become a plural noun. So at last cherry. At last cherry. So cherry is a singular noun, it ending with y. So now we have to change into the plural form. For that we have to remove y and we have to add ies into the noun. So first exercise we learn how we change into the singular noun into the plural noun. If it is a singular noun ending with f, then if you want to change as it into the plural form, we have to remove f and we have to add ves in the first exercise. So now this exercise, if the singular noun ending with the consonant y, we have to remove from the singular noun y and we have to add for the plural form ies. Okay, so now we are going to learn the next exercise. When the noun ends in a vowel plus y. Okay, when vowel plus y, vowels letters we know, no? How many letters are there in vowels? A, E, I, O, U. These letters are called vowels. So if in your singular noun, if the word ending with vowels plus y, so before y, if any letters comes as a vowel, A, R, I, R, E, R, O, U, plus y. If you see here, valley, E is a vowels and y is a consonant. So if the singular nouns comes like that, with a vowels and consonant. If the word ending like that, simple, nothing we have to do. We have to remove y and we have to add s. Okay, for the plural form. So when a noun ends in a vowel plus y, we simply add s. Okay, we simply add s. We no need to remove anything else. Plus that word, only one letter we have to add, that is s. For example, day. So a is a vowel, y is a consonant. So day is a singular noun and days is a plural noun. So likewise, now we are going to change singular noun into the plural noun. Okay, valley. So e is a vowels and y is a consonant. It is a singular noun. The word is ending with vowels plus y. Okay, so now we no need to remove anything else. We just add one letter into the singular noun, then it become a plural noun. So that letter is s. So valleys. See my dear children, we are not remove any letter from the singular noun, but we add one letter is extra for the plural forms, that is s. Okay, so valley, valleys. So monkey. So here also the vowels comes before the consonant. Okay, monkey, e, y. Y is a consonant, e is a vowel. So in this letter also we no need to remove anything else, but we have to add one letter, that is s, for the plural forms. So now monkeys is a plural. Monkey is a singular noun, monkeys is a plural noun. So toy, y is a vowel, y is a consonant. So this noun is complete vowels plus consonant. So now we have to add only one letter, that is s, toys. So again ending with o y, then we have to add s, boys. So here e is a vowels, here also e is a vowels, here o o, two words are ending with o y, that means vowels plus consonant y. So for that we have to add only s into the singular noun for the plural. So way. Way is a way, W-A-Y. A is a vowels and Y is a consonant. So this is a singular noun. Now we have to change singular into the plural. For that we have to add one letter is extra, that is S. So way, ways. Way, ways. So S-A. So here also A vowels and Y consonant ending with vowels plus consonant. So now for that we have to add S, S, only S letter. Okay. Yes, my dear children. In this class we learn how to change a singular noun into the plural noun. So first exercise, the singular noun ending with F, leaf. So that is leaf is a singular noun. So now we are going to change the singular noun into the plural noun. For that, what we have to do? If the word ending with F in singular noun, so we should remove F and we have to add VES into the plural form. This is we learned in the first exercise. In second one, if the letters ending with y, okay, then we have to remove y and we have to add ies. Simple, y is if it is any consonant. Okay, so if it is ending with y, we have to remove y from the singular noun and we have to add ies for the plural form. At last we learn, if the word singular noun, if it is ending with vowels plus y, so what, how many letters are there in vowels? There are five letters, that is a, e, I, o, u. So if in your singular noun the vowels from these five letters, any one letter and plus y, if the word is ending with vowels plus y, then we no need to remove any letter from the singular noun, but we have to add one letter extra in that nouns, then it become a plural form. Yes, my dear children, this is very easy and very interesting lesson. Okay, you may keep it in your mind one thing. Singular means only one. It should be one. Either one boy, one place, one things, one idea. But plural means more than one. More than one person, more than one place, more than one things, more than one idea. It is the plural form. I hope you understand and you clear in singular noun and plural noun. Thank you and have a nice day.